Good morning everyone. I'll be presenting a paper on evaluation of lower uterine segment thickness by ultrasound. Coming to the introduction part, C-section rates are rising throughout the world. Most of the women with previous one C-section would prefer to undergo trial of vaginal birth. Uterine scar dehiscence is an important complication associated with previous LSCS in which there is disruption and suppression of previous scar. The incidence reported for uterine scar dehiscence is between 0.2 to 4.3% of all pregnancies associated with previous cesarean section. Pre-labor diagnosis of uterine dehiscence will allow decision regarding trial of labor. A successful vaginal birth after cesarean is associated with fewer complications than an elective repeated C-section. Ultrasonography can be used to check the integrity of previous scar, and it can be helpful in predicting uterine rupture during labor by calculating the lower uterine segment scar thickness. Coming to the aim of the study, it is to assess the utility of ultrasound in determining the scar thickness in previous C-section to plan for trial of labor after C-section. Coming to the methodology part, it's a prospective observational study done over a period of 6 months. It was done at Father Muller Medical College Hospital upon ethical approval. A total of 62 pregnant women who had history of at least one previous LSCS admitted to Father Muller Medical College Hospital were recruited. Coming to the inclusion criteria, patient with history of previous one LSCS and single term pregnancy with term pregnancy with cephalic presentation were included for the study. Exclusion criteria, with patients with multiple gestation, previous normal vaginal delivery, placenta previa, polyhydramnios or oligohydramnios. Coming to the plan of the study, 62 cases were included in the study. History and thorough examination of all these patients were done. Age, obstetric score, time interval between previous LSCS and subsequent conception, number of LSCS were noted. General physical examination and obstetric examination were done in these patients and scar tenderness was noted. The lower uterine segment scar thickness was assessed by single sonologist by transabdominal ultrasonography on Philips Affinity 70 with a partially full bladder after taking informed consent. Ultrasound was done 24 hours prior to undergoing elective LSCS or in cases of emergency LSCS prior to the surgery without contractions. The lower uterine segment was assessed both in longitudinal and transverse plane under magnification to find out weakened area or rupture. At least two measurements was recorded and the lowest measurement was taken. These sonographic findings were compared with the intraoperative lower uterine segment appearance. During surgery, before extraction, visual inspection of the scar was done. Then after the extraction of the baby, the thickness of the lower segment was measured using a sterile disposable measuring scale. The lower uterine segment scar was graded as one of the following, that is normal, thinned out, dehiscence or ruptured. All the given data were entered on statistical package for social science version 23. The statistical significance was set at a p-value of equal to or less than 0.05. Here the graph shows the maximum participants were in the age group of 25 to 30 years and minimum being 31 to 35 years. Here in this graph it shows that maximum participants underwent LSCS at the gestation age between 37 to 40 weeks, while one of the participants has underwent LSCS at 32 weeks period of gestation in view of IUGR. The above table shows that the mean age of participant was 27 years. The mean gestation age was found to be 37 weeks. The mean interpregnancy interval was 4 years. The mean ultrasound scar thickness as 0.4 cm and interop scar thickness of 0.42 cm with a p-value of 0.005, which is statistically significant. This graph shows that the maximum ultrasound thickness of scar ranged from 0.30 to 0.4 cm, while the minimum being 0.7 to 0.9 cm. This graph shows that the maximum scar thickness noted intraoperative ranged between 0.31 to 0.4 cm. This graph compares the scar thickness measured by an ultrasound and intraoperative. this graph compares the interpregnancy interval with that of the intra-scar thickness. It shows that participants who had 1 to 2 years and 6 to 7 years of interpregnancy interval had scar thickness of 0.8 cm, while with lowest scar thickness was 0.26 cm had interpregnancy interval of 4 to 5 years. So coming to the discussion part in this study, sonographic and intraoperative analysis showed that the p-value is 0.005, which is statistically significant. Studies have suggested that there is inverse relation between scar thickness assessed sonographically and risk of uterine rupture. So other studies where Suzuki et al., Fukute et al., and Rosenberg et al. Also used transabdominal ultrasound to assess previous scar, while Goto et al. Used transvaginal ultrasound to assess the lower uterine segment scar. Their conclusions were similar to our study. Kushtagi et al. Suggested that lower uterine segment thickness of at least 3 mm measured by abdominal ultrasonography before delivery at term in women with previous C-section is suggestive of stronger lower uterine segment, but is not a reliable safeguard for trial of labor. Habishk and colleagues showed that TVS provided more accurate information about the condition of the scarred lower uterine segment than MRI. The main factors that limited the increased use of TVS for assessment of lower uterine segment thickness are discomfort and difficulty in performing the procedure in women at term. Coming to the conclusion, term ultrasound scan by transabdominal or transvaginal scan can be recommended for assessment of scar thickness before planning for trial of labor after C-section. Thank you. These are my references.